All right, my people, it's your boy Frigate TV. Today we're out here with a brother, Foreign Boy. Foreign Boy, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much. Thank you, man.
Yeah, you know, Foreign Boy, recently Foreign Boy has been dropping a lot of content. We want to ask him, he's doing well. So many nice content has been out there, has been put out there by Foreign Boy. Foreign Boy, so tell us, where are you getting this inspiration?
Well, I want to first of all thank you for giving me this opportunity. Also, you've been doing so well, and we appreciate your job, and so far so good. I want to encourage you to keep pushing, and also I'm giving myself that same advice, you know.
Yeah.
So yeah, so we have to keep pushing, you know.
Yeah.
So yeah, back to your question. You know, I know many people might be seeing it like something new, but it's nothing new to me. Like back in the uni days in Oko, Anambra State, where that's where I did my diploma, you know. So I have been acting, you know, but, you know, those acting in the campus and stuff like that, it's really stressful. And because we don't have the finances and the time, you have to go to lectures. You have to do other things as a student. So combining it with acting and stuff like that, it was very difficult. So that's why it seems like I backed out. But at some point, I decided to this is my dream. This is what I can do. This is what I know how to do. So this time I'm back. I'm back, really.
That's good. That's good.
I'm back. Big
happy
time.
To have you here. You know, what did you study, if I may ask? What did you study?
I studied the insurance.
Insurance.
Yes.
So, what gave you this thing, this passion for?
Well,
where did you get it from?
It's something that is in me. You know, acting is not something you just, you know, it's something that is in you. This is talent.
Yeah.
So, and you must have it if you want to go far.
Wow.
Or something like that. So it's something in me. I've been practicing it, and today we want to push it further and see how it goes.
That's good. You're welcome.
Yeah.
Okay, let's go down to the topic for the day. You know,
okay.
Why we invited you over is to ask this question. You know, in Igbo land, precisely. Let me just use it as a case study. There's some families would like their first son to get married first before other siblings or their first daughter. Do you think this is not pressure? Do you think it's good? What's this concept? How do you see it? If you're asked to give your side of it.
Okay. Well, I can relate to that question because I'm an Igbo boy, you know. I'm from Imo State. So I know the pressures on the firstborns, you know, especially the sons.
Yeah.
And I know that in some families, but I don't think it's general. Yeah, but I know that in some families, there are families who still believes that their first daughter or son should get ahead of others, like get married, start being prosperous more than others and stuff like that.
Yeah.
You know, start to achieve things more before others who are their younger ones or something like that. So this concept has been there, okay? And this concept, I think, started when the world is still, you know.
In the primitive.
Yeah. Right now, things are happening, all right?
When
things are happening. Right now, things are happening. We are in the computer age where a boy of 20 years old, a boy of 15 years old, a
can
boy of, you know, do something
explode,
and,
you know,
and
be make that rich and all that.
Exactly. So when that happens, you know, then this boy starts making investment, buying house. So do you want to tell this boy not to do all these things because the elder brother has not done anything for himself?
Has not, you know, achieved his place in life.
Yeah. So from my own point of view, I think it's not
advice
proper.
Not
it's not proper. So, but I respect what people
culture,
believe. I respect
their
culture. I respect what they believe.
Principles.
Yeah, exactly.
But don't you think these things amount to more pressures on this first son? Because when the family wants the first son to get married first before the siblings, and maybe perhaps one of the brother, the younger one, springs up, you know, they have this, and don't you think it creates jealousy, it creates this, you know, this environment of hate, and trying to pressure this first son, he might make a wrong choice of marriage.
Yeah.
Or getting into a relationship with the wrong person just to fulfill or please the family.
Yes. You're right. You're right. You already said it all, because of course we are all human, and when people expect a lot from you, it adds to your pressure, right?
Yeah.
So it adds to your pressure, and when you're supposed to start doing these things first before every other person, it adds to that pressure.
Yeah.
Right. So when your brother starts doing things that you believe you should be doing,
yeah,
then it can create jealousy.
Yeah.
It can create
an environment of hate.
Yes. Yeah. It can create enmity between the family.
Yeah.
Because at some point you see where a mother will be siding to the young man who eventually started making money.
Yeah.
And then maybe some of the family. And you know, then you the first son is gonna see himself being alone in this battle, and it's gonna affect him mentally. It's gonna affect his way of living, you know. So okay. I believe it adds pressure to them.
Thank you so much. So what will you be saying to those first sons that are facing such challenges right now? What are your advice for them?
Well, my advice is they should just be themselves. They should just be themselves and, you know, do what they got to do. Do what they got to do. And it reminds me of a song by Das. He said, to be a man is what you make it.
Yeah.
You know, people trying to live up to expectations. And when they are not capable, all right. So I will advise them to be yourself. Don't let that kind of pressure get to them, because I know sometimes we are human; it can get to you. But do what you got to do. Life is too short, and yeah, just be yourself and do what you got to do. Don't mind those; your time will come. And even though your younger brother gets married before you, that doesn't mean you're not gonna get married.
Yeah, that's true. So okay, let me come in a bit. And for just what you said, advising those guys or the first child's sons that are yet unmarried, you know, that are still unmarried, don't stress yourself.
Okay.
Don't push it. Don't stress it, because, you know, it doesn't matter who gets married first.
Yes.
What really matters is the quality of marriage or the quality of life you have, relationship you have. This is just it.
Yeah.
You understand? Some people will tell you, you need to start making kids. Yeah, that is good.
Yeah.
But the truth is that it doesn't matter when you make the kids, but it's good to just have those kids, at least when you're still healthy and strong.
Much preferable.
Much preferable. So you can at least, you know, fetch for them, you know. And that is it. So what else do you have to say to our viewers, fans, and other people from other part of Igbo land, or families that are, you know, taking this so serious? Parents, precisely.
Okay. My advice to the parents out there who still believes in this, who still believes that their first daughter or their first son should be the one to have everything first before every other child.
Sibling.
You know, so I think they need to, I will advise them to rethink and see how impossible it could be sometimes, because it's not 100% guaranteed that the first son must be the one to break through.
All right.
So they should minimize the pressure on the firstborns and let them be. They are your kids. When it's their time, they will shine.
All right. Thank you so much, Foreign Boy, for coming over for this program to our studio today.
Yeah.
We appreciate you. And don't forget, fans, to share. It's still your boy, Frigate TV. Continue to share, like, and react to those videos.
Yeah.
We'd like to see it fly. Stay tuned and remain blessed. We'll be bringing so many topics for you.
Yeah.
Bye.